Hope all of you are staying safe and staying healthy. And have you all learned what we have learned in the last session? We have learned about subsets, intervals representing on a real number line. Then we have learned about power set. We have learned about universal set and several other things. Hope you all have understood all those. And now we will move on to some questions related to those topics. Let us start with exercise 1.3. We are not going to do all the questions. We will do just some random questions, and you can do the rest of the questions as homework. Look at the first question. Make correct statements by filling the symbols. What does this symbol represent? Subset or not a subset in the blank spaces. This symbol represents a subset and this symbol represents not a subset. Now you have to fill in the correct symbol in these questions. Look at the first one. 2, 3, 4 dash set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Is that a subset? Yes. So we have to fill the symbol with this subset. Then let us do question number 5. Set x such that x is a triangle in a plane dash set x such that x is a rectangle in a plane. These two sets are entirely different sets. So can the set of triangles be a subset of the set of rectangles? It is not possible. Therefore, the fifth question, it is not a subset of. That means the set of triangles is not a subset of the set of rectangles. Hope you understood how to do this question. Please complete all the other rest of the questions as homework. It is just to insert the symbol subset of or not a subset of. Now, we'll move on to the next set. Examine whether the following statements are true or false. That is, just see the question. The statements, you have to state whether all these statements are true or false. Hope all these type of questions you can do by yourself. Then, same thing here in question 3. Which of the following statements are incorrect and why? Here, we will discuss one or two questions. Look, set 3, 4 is a subset of A. You have to look at the question very clearly. Set A is equal to set 1, 2, set 3, 4 and 5. That means 1 is an element of the set A, 2 is another element, 5 is another element and set 3, 4 is another element. So, the first statement, set 3, 4, is that a subset of A? Can set 3, 4 be a subset of A? No. Set 3, 4 is an element of A. If we want to write set of set 3, 4 will be a subset of A. Simply set 3, 4 is an element of A. So this statement is a false statement. Look at the second question. Set 3, 4 belongs to A. Look, set 3, 4 is an element of A. That is a true statement. Third one, set of set 3, 4, double curly brackets represents set of set 3, 4 is a subset of A. Look here, set of set 3, 4, that is a subset of A. Hence, we can say that that is a true statement. Same thing here, the rest of the questions, please complete it at home. Now, question number 4. Write down all the subsets of the following set. How can we write the subsets of the following set? When you consider subsets, to write subsets, we will learn how to write. Let this be a set. Set 1, 2. Writing subset means we have already learned when we have learned subsets. The set itself and null set are subsets of every set. Therefore, while writing subsets, you have to write null set first, then you have to write the set itself. Then you have to write each elements, set 1, then set 2 individually. We have written each elements individually, then we have to go for combinations of 2. That means it's already there. So how many subsets are there? For this set, 1, 2, 3 and 4 subsets are there. Number of subsets of a given set is equal to 2 raised to n, where
n is the number of elements in the set. So the number of subsets of a given set is given as 2 raised to n, where n is equal to the number of elements in the given set. Look here, in this set, the number of elements are 2 and the number of subsets are 1, 2, 3 and 4. Therefore, according to this formula, the number of subsets of this set A, we can write it as 2 raised to 2, which is equal to 4. So please write it as a note. Write these as a note. Number of subsets of a given set is equal to 2 raised to n, where n is equal to number of elements in the given set. Let us consider another example. Capital A is equal to set PQR. So how can we write the subsets of this set? First, null set, then the set itself, then we have to write the individual elements P, set Q, set R, then two elements together, PQ, PR and QR. Three elements together, we have already written it here. So count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. There are 8 subsets for this set A. According to the formula, we have number of subsets as 2 raised to n, where n is the number of elements in the given set. The number of elements here is 3. Therefore, it is 2 raised to 3. That is equal to 8. That is how we find out the number of subsets of a given set. Now, we'll move on to the next question. So, using those, you can do these questions. Question number 4. Write the following as intervals. Look here, the first one. Minus 4 less than x less than or equal to 6. We have already learned that if the inequality symbol is less than it is open and the end point does not belong to the interval. And if the inequality symbol is less than or equal to or greater than or equal to, then it is a closed interval and the end point belongs to the interval. So the first one, how can we write it? It is minus 4, 6. Minus 4 is open brackets and 6 is closed brackets. The second one, here both end points are not included. Therefore, how can we write it? Minus 12, comma, minus 10. Both open brackets, there 12, minus 12 and minus 10 does not belong to the interval. Third one, 0 less than or equal to x less than 7. 0 is included, 7 is not included. Here, 3 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 4. Both 3 and 4 belongs to the interval and therefore we use closed brackets. Next, question number 7. Write the following intervals in set builder form. That means you have to write it in this form. Minus 3, 0. Minus 3, 0 means, look at the brackets. Both are open brackets. Therefore, the interval is an open interval. And the end points minus 3 and 0 does not belong to the interval. Therefore, how do we write it? Set x such that x belongs to the set of real numbers and minus 3 less than x less than 0. 6, 12. 6 and 12, look at the brackets. It is closed brackets and hence the end points 6 and 12 belong to the interval. Therefore, the second one, we can write it as set x such that x belongs to the set of real numbers 6 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 12. Then here 6, 12, but left hand side 6 remains open and 12 remains closed. Therefore, how do we write the interval? We write the interval as set x such that x belongs to the set of real numbers 6 less than x less than or equal to 12. That is, 6 does not belong to the interval and 12 belongs to the interval. Hope you can do the last one by yourself. Question number 8. What universal set would you propose for each of the following? What have we discussed when we have learned universal set? Universal set means a set which is the mother set of a given set. That means if we consider the set of natural numbers, the universal set can be either integers or rational numbers or the set of real numbers. If we take set 1, 2, 3,
Then another set 1, 2, 3 till 10 can be a universal set of the given set 1, 2, 3.
Look here, the first question, the set of right triangles.
It is a given set, the set of right triangles. What can be a proposed universal set of this given set? We can say that the set of all triangles can be a basic set of this set of right triangles, because the set of right triangles can be a subset of the set of all triangles. Therefore, the set of all triangles can be a universal set of the set of right triangles. Similarly, when you move on to all other questions, you will be able to find out a universal set for these given sets. Hope you those questions can also be done by yourself. Now we'll move on to the next topic, that is Venn diagrams. Have you heard about Venn diagrams? Venn diagram is one of the most important concepts that we are learning in set theory. Venn diagram is introduced by a famous English mathematician, John Venn. He lived from 1834 till 1883. Now let us just go through Mr. John Venn's history. He is an English mathematician born in Britain. His father was a priest in an Anglican church, and at the age of 3, he lost his mother. Now, after he completed schooling at Highgate School, Cambridge, he joined for a degree in mathematics in Gonville College, Cambridge, and completed his degree in the year 1857. In the year of 1859, he became an Anglican priest and he served in various churches, various parishes. But he didn't continue that for long. He turned back his career as a lecturer and he joined the Cambridge University as a lecturer. And he started going for intercollegiate lectures and he started his research. And then he invented the Venn diagram. What is a Venn diagram? Now we are going to learn about the concept of Venn diagram. It is a diagram that shows all possible logical relationships between a finite collection of sets. That statement is a bit confusing for you. To explain it more clearly, if we have one or two sets, how can we represent it using a Venn diagram? That means a given set A is there, and how can we represent the elements of that set using a Venn diagram? That is what we are going to learn now. A set in a Venn diagram is always represented as a closed curve. That means a circle. A set is represented using a closed curve, a circle. And the elements inside a set will be written inside the circle. That means if we have a set 1, 2, 3, that is set A. Now, in Venn diagram, we represent it as a circle and we write the elements of the set inside the circle and name the circle using capital letters. This means the set A is represented in the closed curve, that is a circle, and the elements are 1, 2 and 3. Now, for all Venn diagrams, the set is represented using a closed curve, and the universal set of the set, that can be any universal set, is represented using a rectangle. So whenever we draw a Venn diagram, we have to first draw the universal set, whichever set may be, that is the universal set, and the given set A, 1, 2, 3, is represented inside the rectangle. This is how we represent set 1, 2, 3 as a Venn diagram. Now let us consider another example. We have set A is equal to set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. We have set B is equal to 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. C is equal to set 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. How can we represent it using a Venn diagram? The capitals A, the set A is the universal set, and from here itself we can easily understand that B is equal to set 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 as a subset of A, and C is another subset of A. So the first thing, we have to draw the universal set. Here the name of the universal set is set A. Then first set B, write down the elements 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. That is set B. There is another set C. 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. So when we look at this picture, you should be able to understand that B is a set whose elements are 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. C is a set whose elements are 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. And A is a set which contains all these elements in it. Now, let us consider one other example. Capital A is equal to set 1, 2, 3, etc. till 10. B is equal to set 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. And C is another set 2 and 4. How can we represent it using a Venn diagram? So here, B is a subset of A. Look at the set C. C is set 2, 4. That is also a subset of A. But again, look at B and C. Can you establish a relationship between B and C? C is a subset of B as well. Therefore, first you have to draw the rectangle which represents the universal set. Name it as set A. B is a subset 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. B is a subset. And which are the leftover elements in set A that does not belong to set B? That those are 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. These elements does not belong to any other set. Hence, we have to write it in the field of the universal set. And next, set C. Set C is set 2, 4. So where do we represent this set C? Set C is a subset of set B. That means set C is inside set B. Therefore, that 2 and 4 can also be enclosed in another circle and name it as set C. So here we have a universal set A with all the 10 elements in it. Another set B, the big circle, which have 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10, all the 5 elements. And another subset C, whose elements are 2 and 4. And the elements which does not belong to B and C, these two subsets, and which belongs to set A, will be written in the rectangular space without a circle, as these elements does not belong to any subsets which is given here. Hope you all understood the concept of Venn diagrams. So in the next class, we will be learning about union of sets, intersection of sets, complement and several other concepts which are related to sets, and we will be learning more about Venn diagrams and we will discuss some more problems using Venn diagrams. Thank you.